breakfast is served. Favorite thing to make lately, homemade pesto, bunch of basil, pistachios, parmesan. I don't know what else, just makes it. Egg and some chili flakes, it is so good. Good morning, you guys. Welcome back to a new vlog. If you saw my last vlog, which was my first one of 2023, I'm feeling much more myself today, so that's good. If you wanna hear about my resolutions and things for this year, as well as like a little mental health recap chat of how I've been feeling lately and just like throughout this past year, I'll have that video linked. We're not gonna dwell on that today, but it is a lovely Friday here in Los Angeles. It's been pouring, raining every single day of the week. I know, get a grip, right? Like, it rains everywhere in the world, but people here just like don't go anywhere and no one knows how to drive, so then it makes me hesitant to go anywhere because there's just like accidents all the time. And especially especially Northern California, but also here there's been just like a ton of flooding, which is crazy. Kicking off today, it's about 10 a.m. I woke up pretty early and I was like, I'm gonna get out of the house. And so I almost went to go get coffee as like a little Friday treat because I had a gift card, because you know, I'm trying to stay on top of my resolutions and like save money and whatever. We have coffee here. But I was like, I have a gift card. But then I looked all over this whole house and I can't find the gift card. So then that just got me in a bad mood. Then I've been on the phone with a couple of friends today who randomly called me, and now I am like down to the wire on needing to finish, it's mostly done, but just my last vlog that I just talked about that's actually not up at this present moment. So I just need to make my thumbnail, get that up, then may go out and get coffee out of pocket. I don't know. Happy Friday. I hope all of you guys are having a wonderful day and week whenever you see this. And I do have lots to talk about in this video, as always, trying to vlog a lot more this year. All right, hello from the car. It is a little bit later. It's almost 1 o'clock. I've just did something that is so long overdue, which is order a new car tripod mount. Hopefully you can hear me over the engine right now so that I can start vlogging and driving again. I had one in my old car, and then when I switched to this car, so it's been a little bit over a year now, I bought another mount and I just never put it up, and now I have no idea where it is. So anyways, another one is on the way, and I am heading out of the house to go get my little coffee that I was excited for this morning. At this current moment, I'm feeling pretty tired and kind of just more in the mood to just be lazy at home, but I think getting some fresh air and going somewhere that I do love to go, I think I'm gonna have a lot more energy for the rest of my day. And in 2023, what I'm really trying to do is do things based on how I'm gonna feel afterwards, not necessarily if I may or may not be in the mood to do them in the moment, which is weird because we're talking about going to get coffee. But anyways, I think it'll be a fun time. It's just gonna be brief. If there's no parking spot, I'm just gonna come home, and that's a solid chance. I'm going to listen to some Renee rap, who, if you watch Sex Lives of College Girls, she plays Leighton, which is like my spirit animal. I love that character. If you didn't know, she is an amazing singer. She was like on Broadway before that show. She has this EP. My favorite songs in it are called Colorado, In the Kitchen, and Too Well, and I cannot stop. I brought my Kindle in case for some reason there's a seat out there. Maybe I'll read a little bit. Alright, you guys, it is later in the day. It's currently 4:30 p.m. Giselle is at a workout class and then coming home, and I think tonight we're gonna do like a spontaneous date night out just to get dinner somewhere. I'm gonna try to do something a little bit on the affordable side. Another thing I said in my last video when I was talking about resolutions, but we both have a very thorough budget spreadsheet that kind of got off with for like December, just with gifts and everything. I don't get how you're supposed to factor that in. Actually, I'll tell you what I'm doing for that for this year, but I'm back at it. That is one of my goals for this year, is to like keep a detailed budget and track all of my purchases and like categorize those and try to spend just within the amount I've allotted for each category so that I can really maximize my savings. So, or I guess I'll share now what I'm gonna do this year, incorporated into my budget as a category of like savings for every month, is actually set money aside for like a gift category, basically Christmas gifts for the most part, so that at the end of the year, that's kind of already been saved for, and like I can spend within what I've saved for that. And if I go over, like, it's fine, but it's less like I'm just spending like a ridiculous amount of money in December. I still have a little bit of work I need to do today because I haven't edited. I filmed it actually before going home for the holidays, but I haven't edited my video to go up on my main channel this Sunday yet, which is gonna be a healthy meal ideas video, like wintry inspired, hearty
cozy meals. I am so glad I went out and had some time outdoors and like going to do a fun activity for myself. That's something else that I just want to try to do more, is like things out and about just by myself. It was a bit difficult to read there. I found a table, which was lucky, but I just get so distracted like hearing people talk, and especially the content of the conversation beside me. I just like couldn't stop listening to. And then I called my best friend Caroline back on the way home. We were talking some this morning. It's just a big catch up day, which I always love. It feels like a good like wholesome Friday activity, like catching up with some friends. And we talked for like over an hour. And while we were on the phone, I was browsing through my Half-Baked Harvest cookbook. I'll have this one linked. I think there's a few of them that I got for Christmas. I'm wanting to make some new recipes coming up. I'm on a big Indian food kick lately. So I really wanna make her cashew butter chicken. Another day, not today, but I'm very excited to be making some new things. And right now I need a snack. Giselle has been making a homemade hummus that also has some roasted eggplant in there. It's like garlicky, we got the chickpeas, we got a bunch of cumin, it's so good.
If you saw my last video, you also may remember I said I'm only gonna be drinking on special occasions. And so last night we went to eat dinner at one of our neighbor's houses and they were having cocktails, and we just brought over a mocktail that was like an elderflower tonic and some sparkling cranberry juice from Trader Joe's. And then right now, because it's Friday night, we're gonna leave for dinner in like 20 minutes or so. And I just put some kombucha in a pretty glass with one of these little dehydrated citruses, and it looks so cute. And it's just, I think, more the act of just like having something fun to like sip on, to be exciting, switch up your day. Like, that's the fun part of it. This is doing it for me just as much as like a fun cocktail would.
All right, so we ended up snagging a reservation at a little taco spot. This is the outfit of the night. It would look better with jeans, but I just wanted to be comfy. It's really cold out, so I'm wearing my Abercrombie little flowy pants. This top is from Revolve. I have it in black as well, and it's just been a long time favorite.
Date night.
Say hello to the vlog for the first time in 2023.
Hello. We started with this like chip tower with all kinds of, sausage and guac. So pretty in here. Mocktails on the menu. Tonight we have a strawberry and basil mocktail. It's supposed to be a margarita. Giselle, what was yours? A paloma?
Paloma. It's quite loud.
Giselle's been watching Love Island US season 2, and now she's
only two songs, that's it.
Now she's obsessed with Sally.
We jamming. She was like, we're still vibing, don't get out.
I like it.
Aww.
Morgan, Happy New Year. We love working with you. Thanks for your continued support. Kiss, kiss. X's are kisses, right?
Yeah. Okay. You just opened these flowers. I'm so excited. From Fresh Sins. I've never actually seen these in person.
Sorry.
What? No, it's fine. Yeah. Paper. Oh, it's Babylon's paper. Yeah. I didn't see that. Shut up. Get out of here. I literally just bought some of these today to send to my friend for her birthday. I'm not saying who in case she sees this, but this is so exciting. You guys, the details, like the news. So this brand, Fresh Sins, their flowers are always wrapped in a newspaper, and basically the arrangement, you can always preview it on their Instagram before you order, but it's like, you don't get to like customize it at all. It's just based on what is fresh like that day. They're always wrapped in a newspaper, and this one is so cute. It's just like the Fabletics themed words. I just love some good details. Giselle's at it with Love Island back there. But I put them into four little mini assortments. What do we think? I think they're so cute.
Morning from a new day. It is Saturday morning. This is gonna be a 2 days in one vlog. I asked in my last video, kind of towards the end, so I thought I would mention it again. My last vlog was like one long day, like lots of like chatty little talking clips, and it just spanned like one day. And I feel like kind of how I've been vlogging, or at least the second half of 2022, I was more so like vlogging highlights here and there and like compiling a lot of days in one. But I don't know, at this moment I'm kind of feeling more of like the vlogs like this, where it's like a shorter time span and just like more in depth on like those days, even if I'm not like doing the most necessarily. So let me know what you think. As you can see, I have not changed out of my sleep t-shirt yet today. Giselle is currently at a workout class. She has been on her grind, just so on top of it in 2023, so I feel like it's just been very motivating for me as well. As I mentioned, I'm doing the 30 days of exercise video. I'm about to do a little at-home workout, nothing too crazy, because just from my past like workouts this past week, like getting back at it, my legs in particular are feeling so sore. I'm feeling it a little bit in my knees. I've tried to be very careful and just like go through a lot of those movements very slowly. If you didn't know, I've been in I was in physical therapy for a good minute this past year after having like months of extreme knee pain. So learned I was doing basically every workout move involving my legs. Guys, I need my coffee. Involving my legs incorrectly. So I'm trying to be super cognizant about just making sure that I'm doing everything right. With that, I'm going to listen to my body. And today, I think I might do like some ab stuff and just like some body weight. Nothing too extreme on the legs, like more Pilates type moves. I haven't figured it out. I'm just gonna make it like an intuitive movement workout where I just play some music and do what I'm feeling and stretch a lot. I've been seeing a lot of people on TikTok talk about their food fixations of the moment, or hyperfixations, I guess. So right now, my hyperfixation, like this is the thing that I look forward to at night when I go to bed and like in the morning wanna get up to come have this every day because it is so good. It's making like my own at home like sweet cream, so kind of like Starbucks. I don't know, actually it might not be like Starbucks at all, but I just use heavy cream, a tiny bit of stevia, and some of this vanilla bourbon extract from Trader Joe's. And I just mix it up, honestly, until it like starts to lightly thicken, you know, since this will turn like into a whipped cream if you keep going. And I just top my coffee with it and it is so good. And also just making this at home, like, I mean, I don't too often crave Starbucks, but it just feels like I'm having like that kind of coffee experience at home. For the longest time, I feel like I would feel like this guilt if I would use like cream in my coffee for some reason. Does anyone relate to this? I feel like it was with the onset of all like the oat milk, whatever, using all these other milks, that then it's like, feels bad to use like dairy milk, or like, I don't know, like it feels like too indulgent. I used to make my coffee like this a couple years ago and it was so good, and it was like what I looked forward to every day. And then at some point I decided to start like changing that in an effort to like make it healthier. But what's the difference? It's such a small thing, you know? I don't know what I'm saying. It's just that I'm switching back to this coffee.
All right, it is time to finally undecorate for Christmas. These garlands are so dried out that they're like sharp. So Giselle's burned up. What was that?
It's this.
Oh, okay. I thought it was an ornament.
No.
Elderflower tonic.
Ooh. Oh, that's
wow.
So good.
Wow.
Guys, my back feels broken.
And I have allergies.
I know, Giselle's been having like, or it just sounds really bad. I think from like the heat, just drying her out.
And the dust.
And so today we have cleaned up all the Christmas decorations, which is, what time is it? I feel like that took all day. Mm-hmm. It is now so pretty and clean in here. Giselle did a lot of cleaning up here. While downstairs, I've been meaning to tackle the, just like a big closet I have under my staircase that is just full of like everything ever from everything I've ever hosted. And I'm about to redo our bedroom. And so I'm wanting to hold on to the nightstands that we currently have that are from West Elm for the future, whenever there's a guest room situation. But there was no room to store those. So anyways, that's what I did today, was finally clear out so much stuff. There's,
what are you doing? I'm getting out of the shop.
I have just so many things to donate and it's just feeling so much lighter and cleaner in there. And I just want to continue to go through everything in the rest of the house and declutter, because it just feels so good to just feel like I know everything that's in all my spaces. And now I'm going through a bag of stuff that I took out of my old car when I traded it for my new car. And I've never gone through it. It's been over a year. I obviously don't need any of this, but oh, I know what these are. Is there any way to place CDs at this point in life? These are like all the CDs me and Caroline used to like burn for each other.
Aww.
Chill jams from 2016.
Oh, the chill jams.
Jesus jams. Summer 2014.
Giselle just asked if I should film making dinner, but it's literally this. Granted, we've never done it, but we're having Indian From the Trader Joe's frozen section, we got some garlic naan. Butter chicken is my favorite, but very excited for this. We haven't tried them. Giselle said she's heard they're good. Back in December, I tried Indian food for the first time in like 10 million years. Prior to that, I had Indian food once in my life, like early college, and I didn't like it. And please keep in mind, I was raised in North Carolina where my parents didn't have sushi. Like, that was exotic. Like, did not have sushi until like I was in like late college and finally convinced them to try it. So like, they've really broadened their horizons now, but I didn't eat like any cool foods growing up, hardly. So my palate's finally evolved and I really love Indian food. We were eating this, or ordering it, I guess, all the time in December, and it was adding up. So anyways, got the at home cheaper version. I just posted our little mocktails. Getting requests to do some recipes on TikTok for dry January. Let me know if you'd like to see that. What is in this one?
It is some lemon, agave, lychee.
Why did I say water? Lychee?
Lychee. You're probably right.
I don't know.
And elderflower.
Alrighty. It's very good. Alright, here is how it turned out. We're sharing both of them. Looks so good. And then we added some chili flakes for some extra spice. So we'll return with our rating.